Howdy friends, it's Glenn with the Cactus Atlas. Today we're taking a trip back in time. I'm at Fort Verde Historic Park to check out some relics of the Old West. Come check it out with me.
Fort Verde was established in response to fighting Central Arizona Sioux during the Apache and Yavapai Wars. As civilization continued to move further west due to mining, farming, and ranching, settlements were established in areas previously inhabited by various Native American tribes. The Verde River, providing much-needed irrigation for farming, enabled settlers to grow corn and other crops. However, as the population grew, it disrupted the area natives were hunting in. To retaliate, the tribes would raid the crops of settlers. Fort Verde evolved from varying camps around the area until finally built between 1871 and 1873. By the time the fort's construction was completed, much of the tribes lived on reservations, and not much protecting of crops and citizens was needed. At its height, Fort Verde had 22 buildings and spanned 55 acres. One side housed officers, and the other side served as the barracks. By 1891, the fort was abandoned. Eventually, the historic park would open to the public on October 10th, 1970.
And here we are, starting our trip off in the museum. Look at this. This is really neat. This looks like original old stuff. I can tell you for sure, this floor, very old, very rickety. I believe this was one of the original buildings here. It now houses the museum. Let's go take a quick walkthrough and learn a few things. You can actually see a layout of the original fort. Of course, today, I believe where we're going, there are only three buildings left. I think it's these three, if I'm not mistaken, three of the five, so, yep. Oh, check this out. I think these are original uniforms here behind here. 1872 infantry uniform. This is probably what people living around here would have looked like. So this is a pretty neat museum so far. A lot of really neat relics from the past, old photos, all sorts of things in here. A lot of detail to sift through. So if you want to read everything in here, you might need a good hour to do that. This first house behind me is the commanding officer's quarters. Look at that. A relic from the Old West. The signs here tell you that these are three of the original five buildings that once stood in this row. I believe there were a couple here. There's one here, I believe, that burnt down, and another one down a ways this way that we'll see later, whose roof caved in during a freak snowstorm in the area, and eventually it was converted to a barn and then torn down. So the cool thing about this place is, yes, you can go in the buildings. Score. Well, here's one of the rooms. Looks like there's a bunch of Victorian period furniture. You know, if you look around here, it to me looks like old stuff, doesn't it? Representative of the time, and very interestingly, look over there in that corner, you can actually see adobe through the wall. Looks like they busted out part of the wooden wall, or that plaster wall, whatever that is, to reveal what's actually inside of these walls. Adobe. I think next here we can actually go upstairs to the second level. Some really steep stairs here. Check it out, some more adobe here, revealed in the wall.
just amazing that you could build structures with this stuff. It's pretty much just like dried caked mud with like hay and stuff mixed into it. I mean, and if this is exposed to the elements, this stuff just melts away. So I assume they built these walls to help preserve the building. Gives you a sense of what it was probably like to live here. Now this is where the commanding officers lived, so they had it pretty good, if you can't tell. This room here is pretty neat. It's a bunch of children's toys from the period down there, an old rocking horse back there. Really neat. You can actually see out the windows out to the grounds below. Yeah, if I had to live back then, this is where I'd want to be. Just be sure to explore every nook and cranny, because there's more to see. This is like an elegant dining room in here. Hopefully you can make out all that. Look at that delicious bird in the middle of the table. I assume this is all original period furniture and dishes. A lot of the stuff does look really old. Whether it's real or not, it does look accurate to me. This here is known as the bachelor officers' quarters. It's kind of weird because you see this photo right here in front of you, taken at the same porch where people are just sitting out, trying to stay cool, I imagine. You hear that creaky floor? Yeah, you know it's old. Here's another display here. A lot of tools of the trade, it looks like. That old floor, what appears to be original stuff in there. All very cool. Creaking of my feet here on this floor. Yeah, really neat. See some cards and some money on the table. A little cot over here to see how the bachelors lived back then. Those are really neat artifacts. Some belt buckles down here that are pretty neat. Look at those. Okay, so right next to the bachelor's officer's quarters, got an empty lot that once housed, wait for it, the married officer's quarters. This sign has a picture that shows that yes, there was indeed an additional building right here next to the bachelor officer's quarters. Right here. The third building here is the surgeon's quarters. This is where the surgeons would live. They would also do operations in here. Yeah, let's go check this out. I always find 19th century medical tools to be pretty gruesome and torturous looking. I wonder if they have some in there. This first room in here is known as the parlor. Hard to see with the glare again, but this might be my favorite room. I really like the rug and the way they put this together. Once again, I'm assuming this is
authentic period furniture and stuff. Ah, here's what I'm looking for. You can see me, can't you? This would be the surgeon's quarters, it looks like. The surgery room. Look at all the scary looking things there. Tweezers, pliers, a bone saw, it looks like, and various relics of the Old West medical style. And check all this stuff out. Treatment of diseases by electricity. That sounds awesome. Not really. Imagine going to see your doctor today and having a seat like that. I wonder if they at least had cushioning on that. Maybe not. You know, I wonder what kind of gruesome things happened in here. Any amputations? People dying of disease, I assume? You know, back in the day you would have had, I think they had a lot of malaria problems here, especially down by the old fort that was close to the river, but I'm assuming tuberculosis, snake bites, who knows what. This could have been a place that you wouldn't want to hear the screams as you walked by. Or maybe not, I don't know. Maybe I don't give enough credit to 19th century medical technology. When I was doing research online, I noticed like this whole area, I think this is called the parade grounds, if I'm not mistaken. They have a lot of reenactments here that they'll do at certain times of the year where people will dress up in period dress and set up displays, educational booths, things like that. So I'm gonna try to make it a point to come out here during one of those things in the future. Well, there you have it, Fort Verde. This was amazing. I wanna say a huge thanks to the folks that watch our channel that recommended this. So you know who you are. Really appreciate the recommendation. I've known this was here. I just haven't taken any time to come visit it, but yeah, this is really high up on my list. If you like history, if you like the Old West, if you like that era, you can't go wrong.